Happy 2023. Welcome to the new year. Right, so let's get straight into it because I think for many of us, we have New Year's resolutions, we have goals and aspirations, and perhaps they're the same ones from last year that perhaps we didn't quite nail or get round to because life happened. Things got in the way. And this is the point of the video today, is really to get you to reflect on what is the goal, what is the aspiration, what are the intentions that you want, that you've set yourself for this year, and to acknowledge that you have them. But life will happen. Things will happen. You'll have ups, downs. You'll have positive things. You'll have negative things. Hopefully the negatives will be fewer and the positives will be more. But either way, we need to factor in, how do I move forwards in those goals irrespective? And this is where coming down to the activity and the doing of the do, as Betty Boo would say, not focusing on doing it well or doing the quality side of things. Now, I get that there's a lot of focus in self-development, in workplace, and you know, in career development, all that kind of thing, of being excellent, aiming for excellence, striving for better and improvements and all of those things. And that's valid, very right. However, when we're particularly trying to embed a new habit, get something started, get something kicked off, or resurrect an old habit that perhaps has dropped off a bit, we do need to park the expectation we place on it, doing it well, being perfect at it, getting it right, and just doing the thing. And that's the important part of it. Because in terms of habit formation, and this is clear in a lot of the literature, is that really it's about making space for the habit and the action in the day. The thing, whether it's a 10 minute this, 20 minute that, 30 minute this, or an intention through the day to eat healthier, whatever those things are, it is about developing the habit first and making space for these rituals and routines in your day, and then nurturing, then working on quality later. So park the quality and the expectation. Classic example is meditation, if you've ever done it, and I've had lots of conversations with people, I've experienced it myself, is sit down and meditate and you expect it to do it right, to get your head clear, to do all the things that they say you expect from meditation. And actually, that pressure not only can disrupt the meditation practice itself, but can afterwards leave you leaving it feeling like, well, that was rubbish, what was a waste of time. But actually, it's clear from meditation, from exercise, from eating, all of those things, with all the activities that surround health and life, to be fair, I would argue this applies to everything, is that doing the do, making the habit and parking the pressure of perfection, expectation, quality, and just making sure we sweat that sprout, that activity, irrespective of whether I think I've done it well, it's rubbish, I've wasted my time, that's pointless, you've done it, you've achieved it, sweat the sprout and celebrate that sweat. So that's my food for thought really today, because in terms of habit formation, it's really important that we get the habit in, like sowing a seed, we sow the seed and we water it and nurture it and let it grow, let it take root, and over time we'll worry about quality, we'll worry about tweaking it, and this, we won't worry about it, we'll just focus on it. But we get the habit embedded. We make space for it in our life. And in so doing, we can start to adapt our life around it. We can start to make decisions around other things in micro-sized decisions that make sure that habit is protected. When we go all or nothing, it's all in, and then life happens, it's all out. So we need to focus on the small stuff and sweat those incremental steps. So I guess my question for you is, what is the goal? What is the aspiration or intention that you've set yourself for 2023? Or intentions, the plural. And think about how you can shrink that down to a shorter term goal. It's great to have aspirations, really important, but shrink it down to something nearer term, 3 to 3 months or so, something like that, where you've got a goal to work towards. Don't be so rigid with it, but have a rough idea, direction of travel. And then bring yourself back to, what are the day-to-day actions, the one or two actions that will move me in that direction? And make those actions the goal. Not the goal of 3 months. The goal of the goal is not the goal. Bit of a way to think about it, but come back to, your goal is to sweat those sprouts, to make those day-to-day actions count, to happen, and forget the quality. Take the pressure off of expectation and perfection and whatever, and do that. So identify what those actions are, and think about how you'll make time in your day and how you will ensure they'll happen, irrespective of whether you do it well, you do it as committed, as motivated, as whatever as you feel you should. Park the should, park the expectation, and just do the do, as Betty Boo would say. So that's my food for thought for this particular week. And it's really a theme, because as we go through the year, it's how we stay on track with sweating those sprouts, not how we manage to hold back the realities of life. Life will happen. It will be things to renegotiate. There will be sprouts to readapt and sweat. Some to ditch, some do we bring in. But only we're building, we're embedding, and we're growing. And then we can bring in getting better at things. So that's my urging to you. Have a great 2023. Let me know what your goal is and what those actions might be that you want to focus on and how you're going to take the pressure off of that expectation, the quality, the sitting down for 20 minutes or 10 minutes of meditation and expecting it to be rubbish or not good, but still doing it anyway. So take care for now and catch you later.